Hi guys, hope you guys are doing great. Welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can integrate ChatGPT image generation model, the latest one, which is Image GPT-1, with N8N, and how you can generate images using ChatGPT image API. So as you can see on my screen, I have the documentation open and you can see the result, which is awesome. So take a look at this image. If I click on that and click on this image here, you will see the prompt here. And where the text, the king of tomatoes, it's simply looking marvelous, right? And all you have to do is just copy this prompt and give it to ChatGPT and you will get a similar output. And we have some other cool examples as well. And take a look at this one, for example, which is an oil ad, basically an ad where you can see the text is clearly visible and there is no problem writing the text over images. Previously, we had this issue with a lot of different models. We have a lot of different examples as well, and we can also combine the images and edit the images with the API. And first, I'm going to show you guys how you can basically generate the image using N8N with the ChatGPT API. Take a look at this example. Happy 50th birthday. And you can clearly see the text, ultimate travel guide to Japan 04. All of this stuff is completely visible. So really cool stuff. And without further ado, let's start getting into it. So first, I have my N8N closed version already open. And I am going to click on this plus sign here. And then search for HTTP request. Click on HTTP request here. And what I need to do is just scroll down here. And here we have generate images option showing up here. Click on this image API, and from image API, from this drop down here, select curl, and all you have to do is just click on this copy here and then click on import curl on your N8N and paste in the curl command here. Once you paste the curl command, make sure to remove this line here, remove that line, and then click on import. Perfect, you have your node perfectly set up. Now, here we will need to add our OpenAI API key. Now I am going to go to my API key. I hope you already have the account. So I'm gonna go to my platform.openai.com and click on API keys. And then click on create new secret key. I'm going to create a new key, click on default project and click on create secret key. And I have my API key ready and I am going to paste my API key here. And make sure it is right, bearer key. Okay, perfect. And when you scroll down here, you have the option to add in the prompt. But before generating any image, make sure you have your organization verified in API AI platform, in ChatGPT API platform. Because when I go to my platform.openai.com and click on general, sorry, not general, but your profile, where you will see that you need to have this organization verified. And if your organization is not verified, you will get an error in your node that it is not working. So make sure your organization is verified. They will ask you for the government ID or something like that in order to verify. Once you are verified, you can then follow this process to generate the image. Okay, we have a prompt ready and I am going to simply test that up to see we have our image generated. And our prompt is a children broke drawing for a vegetarian using a stethoscope to listen to the heartbeat of a baby otter. Okay, a big prompt. Let's see what we get. Click on test step to see the result generated. Okay guys, we have our image ready to be visible. And if I click on show data, we have this, which is a B64 JSON, right? And we will have to now convert it to our base64 to an image basically. So I'm gonna add in another node here and then search for base64. And here we have a node which will basically convert the binary data from JSON. I think that's the one. Yep, here it is. Convert to file, convert JSON to binary data. So we will go to this here, move base 64 to string file, add this node here, and we will basically add this data, drag and drop it here. So drag and drop this here. And once we click on test step, you can see that we have our image data showing up. So click on view. And you can see that the prompt which we added has generated the image. So that's how you can generate the image using the latest image GPT Image 1 model using N8N. Okay, now after generating this image, you must be thinking that how much it would actually cost me. So the GPT Image 1 model, which is expensive as compared to DALL-E 2 and DALL-E 3, it is basically going to cost you about 15 cents to 30 cents for each image generation. Now the image which we generated is this here, which is 3.19 MB of size, a good quality, a fairly decent one, but it actually costed us a lot as compared to the other models. If I go to the usage and check out the pricing, you can see that this is the only image which I have generated so far from this API key, and it costed us about 25 cents. Now you can reduce the cost of image generation by adding the parameters and customizing the image. So we have option to add the parameters for different sizes, for different qualities. And if I go to image generation documentation here you have this customize output. And if I click on that, here we have these option where we can add size, quality, background, and these parameters. So these are the available sizes, and these are the quality options which we have. So all we have to do is just go back to our node here and add in additional parameters here below body parameters. So we would add, click on add parameter, add in size. And in size, we have these values, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the four values which we have. So we can simply copy and paste here. This one is lowest size, which we can add to reduce the cost of image generation. And we can then add another parameter for the quality. So quality options, we can add in this parameter here, and we can now add in the value here, low, medium, or high, or auto, which will give autonomy to our model that decide whatever you want to generate, whether it's high quality, low quality, or medium quality. So that's how you can reduce the cost of ChatGPT image generation. And now I am going to show you guys how you can basically combine two images and generate a new image using GPT Image 1. So if we scroll down here, we also have the option. We also have the masking option, but I'm not going to go over the masking one via N8N, but we can combine the images via N8N and generate new image. So you can see here, we have these four images and we have combined this to one new image. Here you can see in this example, four input images were given to ChatGPT and ChatGPT generated this image here. So let me show you how you can combine images with N8N as well. Now guys, let me show you guys how you can merge multiple images and create a new image, right? So this is a workflow for generating one image. I am going to create a Google Drive node in order to add in the image. So we will be merging two different images and generate one new image, right? So let's click on Google Drive. I am going to click on download file. And here I have two images, which I'm going to combine and generate a new image. So these are the two images. That's the one image. So if I click on test step, you can see that's my first image, right? And now let's add in another Google Drive node. So I'm just going to duplicate that. And here I am going to select the second image which I have in my Google Drive. Okay, that's the second image which I have. Click on test step. And here is the second image, right? So that's the second image. And that's the first image. right? We will be combining these two images and creating a new image using ChatGPT API, GPT Image 1 API, right? And now we will need to add a merge node. Here we will combine the two inputs by position. So we are combining these two inputs and connecting these with the merge node. And then we will add an HTTP request node and do the same thing just like we did here. So add in the HTTP request node, and in HTTP request node, we will import the cull command from our image generation documentation. So that is for editing the image. And if we click on image API and then copy this cull command and try to import the command by clicking on import cull, paste the command here and click on import, it is going to basically throw you an error. Right now, there is a solution for that. I use ChatGPT to give me an updated command, and the command is this one here. So that's the cull command, which I will be using. You can also use ChatGPT to fix the cull command and import that, or you can simply click on the link in the description where I have this command added already. So I'm simply gonna copy this command and go back to this import cull command here, paste my cull command, and then click on import. Okay, perfect. And once you have the cull command imported, you can see that we have this input, which is a one image input. We will be adding another parameter with the same setting. So N8N binary file. And here we will simply copy. And now on the input data field name on this one and this one, we will point our binary data, which is coming through the previous nodes, right? To generate the new image. And obviously you will also need to add in the API key. So let me add in the API key from this old node, which we had set up for generating an image. So I'm just going to copy this API key and then paste on my HTTP request node, right? And now let's first test this merge thing, because if we were testing a lot of HTTP request node, our API key will basically drown our credits, right? So let's check out the merge node first, that if we are getting the two different binary data in this merge node. So let's delete this from here. I'm gonna test it just like this. And now let's click on test workflow. Okay, we have two inputs and one output. Now, when I click on merge node, the output which I have is just one item. We should have two items, which we can then pass to HTTP request node. The reason why it is happening because that we have both output as data in our Google Drive node, right? And when it passed on to merge node, it basically overrides and only shows us the last data output, meaning it is just giving us one field. It's not actually merging the two inputs and giving out two different outputs in one list. So what we can do here is we can add a code node here and rename the key of this node. So output of these two nodes is the data. Same on this one here and on this one. And we need to change one of the item to something else. And for that, we will need to add a code node. So I'm going to add a code node. And that is the code which you can use. Again, code will be in the description. All you have to do is just then copy and then go back to the N8N and paste the code, right? And here it will just rename data to data_1. So we are changing this key from data to data_1, right? And now let's go back to Canvas. And here is our code node. So this one, the key will be data. For this one, it will be data_1 after going through this code node. And now let's test the merge node here. Perfect. Now we have two images merged in our merge node. And here we have the binary data for these two images, right? Now we will pass it on to HTTP request node. And here we will simply add in data here, which is our first output. and data underscore one here, which is our second output. Now we are merging these two images and creating a new image, right? And let's do that. Click on test this step. Okay, we have another issue here, which is saying that response format is unknown parameter. So we will delete that. So delete that response format, which is an invalid parameter. So I'm going to remove that and I'll click on test this step. Okay, here we go. We have our image ready and we have our base 64 data. Again, we will convert it to the file by adding a node, which is convert base 64 to, let's search for that, convert JSON data to binary data. And from here, we will select move base 64 string to file. So we will convert 64 string to file data. Okay, and here we will drag and drop the data which is generated from the last HTTP request node to this input field here. And now when we will click on test the step, we will have our file ready. So we have our file ready and it's in a PNG format and the file size is 1.78 MB. And here we go. So you can see that it has generated an awesome looking image and combined two images into one image using API with N8N. Cool, right? And for the prompt, you can see that in the HTTP request node, that is our prompt. Generate a photorealistic image of a gift basket on a white background, label relaxed unwind with a ribbon and handwriting and all of this prompt. And at the end of it, it says the items in the reference picture. That is really important that we are giving it a prompt that we want the image generated with the reference pictures, which we have added in this binary file here with the data and data underscore one. So that's how easy it is. You can generate image with HTTP request node and also combine. Also, there is native node as well, which is present by OpenAI. So if you search for OpenAI node and you basically click on generate an image, you can generate the image and it has these three different models, DALL-E 2, DALL-E 3. We use GPT image 1. But in this case, you will not be able to merge the image and generate new image using the reference images. So in order to merge the image and generate a new image with the reference image, this OpenAI node will not work till now, but they may add this feature later on. But currently it is not in the N8N right now. I am using the latest version of N8N. So that's it for this video, guys. I'm also going to add this workflow of N8N in the link in the description. So you can download this workflow and generate images using ChatGPT Image 1 API. Let me know in the comments below what more you would like to learn. I would love to create more tutorial related to N8N. Until next video, have a great day.